Azure SQL provides several connection policy settings that may have a positive impact on the performance of your application. Now, Anna is here to tell us how and when to use this and how to set it up today on Data Exposed. Hi, and welcome to another episode of Data Exposed. I'm your host, Jeroen, and today I'm joined by Anna to talk about connection policies. So welcome to the show.
Thanks.
And connection policies, so what do I need to know about that?
Yeah, so basically in Azure SQL, there are different ways that you can connect to your database or manage instances.
Okay.
We had someone on the show, I think you might have spoken to him.
Mm-hmm.
He did a few videos on this topic. So
right.
We definitely recommend if you're new to this topic, go check out Rohit's videos and then come back here.
Okay, cool. So suppose I check them out. So what? How do I use this? Can you show me a little bit about how I do this?
Yeah, sure. So we will go ahead and flip, since you guys are hopefully now familiar with this,
mm-hmm.
to Azure Data Studio. And what we're going to do is we're going to use the Azure CLI to determine what the connection policy is. So there's three options that might be the default, redirect, or proxy.
Okay.
And through this exercise, we'll kind of compare them and see, I've heard some things about one being faster, so
okay.
We'll maybe see what it looks like.
Cool. So, yeah, let's get started.
Great.
Yeah.
So the first command to look at is this AZ SQL Server con policy show. And what this is going to do is show you what your policy is.
Okay.
Now, this should be set to the default policy,
mm-hmm.
and what that policy does is, you see that default here, that policy means that for everything within Azure, we're going to use the redirect policy, and what this means is, like, initially we'll go to the gateway,
mm-hmm.
and once it's all good there, we can actually connect you just straight to the database. And
okay.
So the argument there is that it's a little bit faster, so by default within Azure we'll do that. And if it's something outside of Azure, we'll actually proxy you through a gateway
okay.
every time.
Okay.
So that's what the default is set at.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if we wanted to update it to proxy, just to see, we'll run a little test and see what's faster. I can go ahead and run this, and same sort of commands. I just say update the connection type to proxy, and then we'll just go ahead and confirm that worked.
Okay.
Now we've gotten confirmation that now we're running in proxy.
Mm-hmm.
So what we're going to do is we're going to try a little test. This isn't like super official or anything, but if I hop over to SSMS and I create a new query, I can go ahead and run this command, and I'm going to include client statistics so we can try to
right.
get an understanding of what that network latency is.
So you're now basically just going to query a very simple query against this database for which you just updated connection policy.
Exactly.
Right?
So
okay.
this go 20 means kind of do it 20 times,
mm-hmm.
and we're actually going to do 10 iterations of that. So we'll just go ahead and do that and then look at our results.
Okay.
Okay, so we've run this 10 times, and now we can use client statistics to actually take a look at the average over those trials. And what we're going to look at is this last value, and that's the wait time on server replies. So this gives some indication
right.
of the network latency that we're hitting. So
mm-hmm.
Here you see we're getting 48.5. So if you just hold that in your head,
sure.
We'll try it again with proxy and see what happens.
Okay.
So now if I go back to the notebook, what I can do is kick off this command. And you see we're using the same command, so AZ SQL Server Connection Policy Update, except now we're going to change everything to redirect. So
okay.
this means everything, once it gets information from the gateway, will go straight to the database.
Okay.
And so we're hoping to see an increase in performance or a decrease in that wait time on server
okay,
replies.
Okay, so we're expecting a decrease here. Cool. So let's do the same experiment again.
Exactly. So
mm-hmm.
I'm just going to go ahead and copy that command, go back to SSMS, open a new query, so we want a fresh connection,
right?
And include client statistics, and we'll run that 10 times. So we've run this 10 times, so we'll take a look at our client statistics. Again, we're going to look at the wait time on server replies. And immediately what we notice when we look at our average, this is 22. Do you remember what the wait time?
48 and a half.
So, you know, in this case, it's less than half the latency that you're hitting. So this can really help in those scenarios where you have a really chatty application.
Right.
Or just you're running at an enterprise level.
Okay. So basically, by running these commands, I can change the setting. But you're saying I shouldn't be using it all the time, right? Only in very specific scenarios?
Well, it will depend on your scenario and the restrictions that your organization has, because running this redirect policy does require you to open up a few more ports.
Okay.
So it really is going to depend on your scenario. And, you know, of course, you should do your own testing to make sure it does result in performance.
And follow all the security rules that the company you're working with.
Exactly. Yeah.
Sets. Okay. So it's not a silver bullet. I was almost tempted to say, oh, you should set it to redirect all the time, but that's not entirely the case. Cool. Oh, thanks. Thanks for showing that. I hope this was useful. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe, leave a comment, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.